Hi everyone, welcome to NourishEye Technologies. This is Srinivas. In this video, I am going to explain how to check whether the input number is a Armstrong number or not. First of all, what is Armstrong number? So with the example, I'll explain. Suppose I considered one value is a 153. This is Armstrong number. How it become Armstrong number means what? Just here it is, the first digit power 3. And here it is the second digit power 3 and the third digit power 3, just cubes. If you add, then it is Armstrong. So 1 cube is a 1, so 5 cube is a 125, and next one 3 cube is a 27, and that value will give is a 153, exact number it is giving. So this is what Armstrong number. So in the last video, clearly I mentioned how to find the sum of digits in the given number, sum of digits in the given number. Now in this example, after finding the digit, instead of adding directly, just make it power 3, just cube operation, and then add to the sum. And finally check that n value and that finding what you found, that sum value, if both are same, so directly you can say that it's a strong number, it's a Armstrong number, right? See how to write the code. So execution starts with the main. Just we are reading one number, n. We are reading n. Just consider the same example we are taking, that n value is a 153, consider 153. Now we are repeating that loop. Is a while loop, is n is greater than 0. Until n value becomes 0, we need to perform this loop. First, we are getting that last digit 3. How to get the last digit? We know that. Just perform that remainder operation. N mod 10. It will give that remainder. The remainder is what? 3. 3. Now, we need to find out the cube operation for 3. Here it is what? After performing that cube, like for example, cube, we are declaring one variable, extra variable we are taking, cube, and just r is multiplied with r is multiplied with r, multiplied with r. So initially, suppose we are taking the value is a 0. After multiplication, sorry, here it is that you are multiplying, right? So any r value, r cube. So that we are storing into cube, just declaration is enough, not required anyway, because we are performing that cube operation on R. And finally, the result we are storing into that cube. Now that cube value we are adding to sum. We are taking one value sum equal to 0 initially. The cube value we are adding to sum. We are adding to sum. Sir, can't you write here it is r is multiplied with r is multiplied with r directly here? Yes, you can, no problem. So that here it is no need to declare that cube variable again. So you can save the memory. You can save the memory. That is completely depends on your logical skills. Here it is, I am explaining more clearly. Right, if you want to remove some of the variables and if you want to submit the expression directly here, that's your wish. Right, here it is that cube value. 3 cube value is a 27. So that will go and store into sum. After working with this one, right, n value, I just want to change it to 15. How? N equal to n by 10. N value become 15. Again, the same loop will repeat. Here it is 15 is greater than 0 condition, true. Come inside. N mod 10, it will give that value 5. R value 5. So, 5 into 5 into 5, 125 will go and store into that cube. That 125 we are adding to this sum. Here it is 125. Plus 27 is value is a 152, and here it is n by 10, so n value become 1. Again loop will repeat. 1 is greater than 0 condition, true. Come inside. N mod 10 means what? It is not divisible, it will give that remainder 1. So 1 cube is a 1 only, that will be added to sum. Sum value become 153. And next, whenever n value becomes 0, 0 is greater than 0 should stop. Now we are checking if n value and sum value both are same, then here it is, we can say that it's a printf It's an Armstrong number. Else, it's not an Armstrong number. That you can write. Else, not an Armstrong number. Here you will face one problem. So what is that problem? Here some value is 153 is okay. But see now, n value is initially 153, but finally what is that n value? 0 is a problem. So every time we are changing the value of n, right, finally n value becomes 0 always. We need to check some value and n value. That is the reason we are taking one extra variable called temp. So before going to perform this operation into temp, I am storing that n value. Initially what is that n value? 153. So temp value is a 153 initially. So once your logic done, before going to check into n, we are recollecting the temp value after finding this sum. Once this while loop execution completed, the temp value again recollect into n. Here it is, temp value 153, that will be stored into n. So n become 153 again. So now if you check, you will get the answer correctly. So temp variable is very, very important because every time we are modifying the n value. So this is the way we are checking the input number is an Armstrong number or not. Hope you understood. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh IT channel. Thank you.